Hi, everybody, and welcome back to the latest and greatest episode of The Frost Bite. With me, your hostess with the mostest, your bestie who's a vestie, the cringiest crossdresser on YouTube, Vivian Frost. Now, this is the second time I've done this episode because I did it a couple days ago, and the video was choppy as fuck. If you want to see a, you know, still frame every 2 second original version of it, let me know in the comments down below. But anyway, I have gathered you all here, and I was dressed to impress as always, then as I am now, to talk about the films of one of my favorite directors. He was on my Mount Rushmore. If I was smart enough, I would say check out that video right here. Maybe I will, but I probably won't even remember any of this tomorrow or the next day whenever I upload it. Anyway, David Lynch, or Lynch, depending on, you know, how drunk I am. But he only has 10 films, so it makes perfect for a top 10 list, because you could literally rank every one of his feature films in a top 10 list. Let's get fucking started. So let's, as Lynch likes to do, because he has a thing for curtains, like Tarantino has for feet, let's peel back and reveal the crossdresser behind the curtain. Me, of course, obviously, Vivian Frost. But my 10th favorite David Lynch film is the most un-Lynchiest film of them all, which is The Straight Story. There's a lot of motifs that you recognize as very Lynchian, but it's a far cry from pretty much every other film on this list. Let's just put it that way. Good movie, well acted. Richard Farnsworth absolutely was phenomenal. God rest his soul. Shot himself on his porch. Sad story. But that's The Straight Story with Richard Farnsworth and Carrie herself, Sissy Spacek. Old school. Used to be reverse. Now it's on this side. Left side. Right is not right anymore. Vote left. Anyway, The Straight Story. That's my pick for numero 10. Moving on up, we have The Elephant Man. Now, oh, that's low. He's only got 10 films. And again, this is a Lynchian biopic, or biopic, depending on if you're, you know, my significant other who loves to say it that way, which it just sounds dumb to me. It's biopic. I don't know. Let me know in the comments. Sound off. Who's right? Who's wrong? Help me win an argument. Say it's me. Anyway, The Elephant Man, the true story of John Joseph Merrick, Jingleheimer Elephant, born with elephantitis, hence the name The Elephant Man. Anthony Hopkins is great in it. Is it William Hurt? It's William or John Hurt, one of them. Can't read the fucking writing on the poster to know which one it is. It's one of the Hurt boys, I'm pretty sure, that plays The Elephant Man. But heart-wrenching, beautiful, black and white, gorgeous, phenomenal. You know, and it's not Lynch's only black and white movie, because he also did Eraserhead, his first, like, film. And now I just want to say something. If you watch this film and think, first off, two things. If you watch this film and you're like, I don't know what to think, but that was, I don't know if it was good or bad. That is normal. That is perfectly normal. But if you want more of that, that's when you go down the yellow brick road to the Emerald City of David Lynch. But Eraserhead, Lynch himself has said that nobody still has figured out what this film means, and I didn't have my repeat on, so my unlicensed music is playing. Now, hopefully it doesn't flag the video. But anyway, we just keep it going because it's live. Yes, that's right. I'm director, producer, actress, writer, improvisationer, everything, drummer, whatever, vibrator, dildoer, expositioner, I don't know, all those things. The weed's kicking in, y'all. It's going to go downhill from here. But Eraserhead, if you've seen it, you fucking know what I'm talking about. And if you didn't like it, maybe Lynch isn't for you, and that's totally fine. But we're moving on up to Lost Highway. Soundtrack slaps. Still fucking slaps. Bill Pullman, President of the United States, fucking amazing. This is the perfect Lynch film for, like, when I was graduating high school. Because that's when it kind of came out. It was when I was in my, you know, junior, senior year of high school, and everybody was about getting high at somebody's different house each week and watching Lost Highway. Fucking incredible. You just, again, like most Lynch stuff, it's really hard to categorize and explain, and you don't want to, because you just want people to, you just go in and watch it. Just go, this is a David Lynch film, and you sit down and you watch it, and it's heaven on earth. Not like Inland Empire, at least for Laura Dern, slight spoiler there, but an Oscar-worthy performance by Laura Dern, Dr. Ellie Sattler herself from Jurassic Park, daughter of Silent Running Bruce Dern. Anyway, David Lynch's Inland Empire. This movie's a fucking trip. It's like, it's Mulholland Drive without all the subtext, in a sense, if that makes sense, sort of. Maybe it doesn't, maybe it will. it's Lynch. It makes sense to me. That means it's true. So that's the bottom line when it comes to David Lynch. Inland Empire, if you haven't seen it, if it's a blind spot in your David Lynch filmography, you know, rewatch, whatever you want to call it, exploration, journey into the darker side of humanity, you know, peering what's behind the fucking curtain, so to speak, this is a good one that'll test you. Almost as good as Wild at Heart. Now, David Lynch loves The Wizard of Oz. They're pretty much Wizard of Oz references in almost everything he does. Just believe me, look for red shoes. There you go, ruby slippers, red shoes. It's correlation. Curtains, man behind the curtain, as we talked about. It's there. The fish out of water thing is in everything Lynch. Wizard of Oz is his Citizen Kane. And nowhere is that more apparent to me than Wild at Heart. The one true God, Nicolas Cage. Hail he who walketh up my row. And of course, again, Laura Dern, David Lynch's filmic muse, his DiCaprio to Scorsese, if you will, and I think you do. But Wild at Heart, again, this is one you just gotta fucking watch it. It's like David Lynch's True Romance, but Natural Born Killer. It's so much, but it's all Lynch, and it predates the examples I just gave. So, again, the genius of David Lynch. Moving on up, his first really big, widespread, critically acclaimed film with Blue Velvet. Frank Booth, a.k.a. the late, great Dennis Hopper, R.I.P., Easy Rider. As Frank Booth, one of the greatest villains of cinema history because he's so fucking real. Like, I've seen people like this. I've been solicited by people like that. And believe me, thankfully, this movie saved my life because I didn't fucking go along for the ride, although kind of, the older I get, I think I'd have been okay. I think it'd have been a great memory. Anyway, Blue Velvet. All that makes sense if you've seen the movie. You haven't seen the movie, know what I'm talking about? Well, you need to watch fucking Blue Velvet. If you please. That's Black Velvet, isn't it? Damn it. Next we have, now this one, most people are probably surprised it's this high on my list. That's because I grew up on this fucking movie. This was my first David Lynch movie. And if you ever wanted to see what David Lynch would do with a sci-fi film, watch David Lynch's Dune. And most importantly, write the Spice Something Cut. Google it. The Spice Runner, Spice Diver, Spice Diver Cut of Dune, where it combines like the two versions into one, and it's the definitive version. It's fucking amazing. And again, a bit of a nostalgic pick for me, but David Lynch in fucking space. Sold. And then we have my second favorite David Lynch film, Twin Peaks, Fire, Walk With Me, R.I.P. Laura Palmer. Or is she? Or is it just this world's Laura Palmer? Oh my God! Anyway, you watch Twin Peaks, one of the greatest, if not the greatest TV show ever made. And The Return, Twin Peaks, The Return, Episode 8, the one with the atomic bomb, greatest episode of television in history. Every time I watch it, I stoned. It means something different and hits so fucking different. It's just fucking incredible. But anyway, about the film, Twin Peaks Fire Walk With Me, because guess what? You know, I know this is hard to believe for a lot of you youngins today, but yep, old crossdresser is yelling at the cloud, like the literal digital cloud. Anyway, because I just found out today some of my picks weren't backed up, and that fucking makes me angry. Anyway, Twin Peaks Season 2, if you watched it, if not, shame on fucking you. Watch Twin Peaks today. That is the life lesson of today's video. The more you know part, do-do-do-do, is Vivian saying, watch Twin Peaks. Truth, trust, all that shit. Hail Satin. Anyway, we were left with, like, what the fuck? It was really like, what the fuck? And they never, like, it was still ambiguous as to what was going on, but this movie proved, with it beyond a shadow of a doubt, what happened to Laura Palmer. Because you can never trust anything in Twin Peaks. He did it. She did it. They did it. Who did it? It kept, like, changing. Then, like, you think they're telling you this person did it, but you never truly believe it until, I mean, at least I didn't, until Twin Peaks Fire Walk With Me, one of the most disturbing movies ever made. Fucking incredible acting. Not Laura Dern. Vampires. Cheryl Lee. Pretty sure it's Cheryl Lee, right? Shirley, fucking amazing actress. Absolutely. Like, nobody could have done Laura Palmer. Like, legit. You could have got Meryl Streep, it wouldn't have been the same. She fucking is Laura Palmer. She was the perfect actress for that role. But anyway, obviously, I've named 9 of David Lynch's movies. That means my favorite one is obviously Mulholland Drive. Because this was the first, like, real Lynch movie. Like this, when I think of David Lynch, I think of this movie. This is the most Lynchian film of everything, even more than Eraserhead. Seriously. Mulholland Drive, every time I watch it, I get deeper. Like, you have to, like, legit. You see, some people say, like, you don't like pot? Well, you got to smoke it, like, 20 times or 5 times. Smoke it again. You'll like it kind of shit. Mulholland Drive is like that. It's literally like, I am a minor, M-I-N-E-R, not O-R, you fucking perverts. I know I look that young, right? Anyway, this is, like, every time I watch it, I get deeper and deeper. I'm finding my way through the maze of Mulholland Drive, and I don't know how many times it's going to take. Let me know in the comments how many times it took you to understand it. Like, and do you? That's my question to you, is do you really? Because this movie is so complex, it's so deep, it is the quintessential and best David Lynch film. So, by now, as always, you should be subscribing right here, because that's what you're supposed to do, and you're supposed to say, like, that's a fucking chill on these videos. But I seriously, more than subscribing, let me know what video this one is down in the comments below, because this is based on all the other weird shit you watch on YouTube, and inquiring minds want to know. But as always, signing off till next time. Nia sex time. Stay fucking frosty.